The original idea was to test these two batteries, one with and one without the Batteroo. Number one was without, number two was with, in my 3-watt, at least it was supposed to be 3-watt LED flashlight. Well, even though these are as cheap of batteries as you can get, unfortunately, without the Batteroo, this little bugger was at 9 hours and still shining bright. Wow. Unfortunately, my largest memory card will go to about 6 hours worth of video recording. So that wasn't really a good solution. I couldn't record the whole thing. And it still was shining. So I never even got to try the Batteroo. Then I remembered I have a special battery testing unit. It's actually meant for charging batteries, but it can also discharge and benchmark. I don't have any more brand new, other than this Batteroo one that I haven't touched yet, I don't have any more brand new AA batteries on hand except for Sunbeam, which is Dollar Tree brand, or the Dollar Tree store brand. And these are also carbon zinc. So, between Harbor Freight and Dollar Tree are the two cheapest batteries you can really get in the U.S. I mean, just short of free, but brand new batteries for free. Yeah. So, why are they not coming out? Oh, that's why. They double wrapped them. This one was still going strong, and even after like 9 hours of my flashlight, it would still power my flashlight, and it even still worked in my mouse. So there we go, got two brand new ones. And what we're going to do is we're going to put one in the Batteroo, and we'll put that one in slot, what slot is this? Three, we'll say. If it recognizes. Yep. 1.68 volts. Let's try this one. 1.68 volts. Now they're both. And I gotta keep pressing this, otherwise it'll override and just automatically try and go into charge mode. We don't want to charge these. That would be bad. This I can set discharge. And we're gonna set it at its lowest, 200 milliamp. And we are going to let it go. And we're going to see both how long it takes and how many total amps, milliamps, it's able to pull out of these batteries. So, and now this is fully automated. I have no control. And given we started both at the same time, they should be both, and they're both right next to each other in the same package. So this should be about as good of a test as we can get. Remember, Batteroo, not Batteroo. 1.68 volts yet. So far, should we leave it on the milliamp screen? Yeah, why don't we do that? I can come back once in a while and actually check and see what is going on. And you guys can watch it count up.
Things reserved, six bits of all things, some of them. body frail, chewing on their fingernails. They were waiting for the man from
Our tests are done. Now, the results, I've been watching this as it's been draining the batteries. So, it's kind of interesting. Now, this one has the Batteroo, and this one is the straight battery. The one that's the straight battery without the Batteroo, we were able to withdraw 611 milliamp hours out of it, which is a lot for these cheap batteries. The one with the Batteroo shut off at 384 milliamp hours. Why? Because the Batteroo did the exact opposite of what it was supposed to do. Instead of maintaining the voltage for a longer period of time, it actually decided to cut the voltage off too early, thus tripping the tester to stop taking power out of the battery. Whereas the one without allowed the tester to continue going. So the one without managed to run for 3 hours and 4 minutes, and the one with the Batteroo only ran for 1 hour and 56 minutes. That's quite a big difference. So in actuality, the Batteroo did the opposite of what was supposed to happen. And basically, we only got a fraction of the power out of the battery. Good old Siri. Hey, Siri. Hey, Siri. Hey, Siri. What percent is 384 of 611?
The answer is about 62.8477%.
So, the one with the Batteroo only outputted 62% of the power, we'll round up, 63%, just to be nice, of the one without it. This product is a complete and utter failure. It's a sham. It has not worked in a single device that I've tried it in, how it was advertised. Nothing close. And if this doesn't show that it doesn't work, just Batteroo's own video on their website just makes the guy look like a snake oil salesman. I mean, stereotypical. Garbage. Absolute garbage. And these were both brand new batteries, straight out of the package. Garbage. And Batteroo is refusing to refund my money. And so I will be doing a chargeback. So, the reason why the voltage went back up is under load, the voltage dropped down low enough where this thing actually shut off. So, because it shut off so early, it became a useless thing. And then because it, at rest, the battery starts going back up in voltage slightly, not always, not back to full, that the voltage will start to climb, which is why the voltage ended up going up. Now, I probably could have restarted the test 2 or 3 times, and it probably would have gotten a little bit more out of it. But under load, that battery voltage would just drop too much. So this is, my God, one of the snake oilies. And the theory and the science behind it is somewhat sound, or is sound, but it failed. The implementation of it is just not done right. And such high hopes for it. I mean, this, I actually really wanted this to work, because I could find a few uses for it, but it just, I can't even express my disappointment at this time. So, if you are considering buying a Batteroo, just don't. Save your money. Just buy some rechargeable batteries. Charge them a little more often. You're better off with the rechargeable batteries, because each sleeve, not even counting shipping, ends up costing about $2. And I've only used this one a couple. I've had these for a couple days, just doing some testing, and this is pretty much worn out already. I've tried it in about 20 different devices. Most of them, it doesn't fit. End of story.